I'm in the North Carolina Triangle, formed by Raleigh, Chapel Hill, and Durham. And I'm getting ready for the Roast Grills Hot Dog Challenge. Finish 17 Franks covered in mustard and homemade chili in just 1 hour. Over 100 have tried and failed. So to defeat these dogs, I need the help of the most intense basketball fans in the Triangle. Duke University's Cameron Crazies. I gave them hot dogs, and they give me inspiration. I'm gonna chew these chili dogs up. Fight ain't easy, and it's all gonna come down to the buzzer. I crushed those Franks, and now I'm ready to eat some. I head over to the Roast Grill in Raleigh. For over 70 years, it's been serving up the most famous Franks in Carolina. Crispy grilled hot dogs smothered in homemade chili. And on a fateful day in 1998, a local put down 13 of those wieners in under an hour, and a challenge was born. Today, the record stands at 16. And if I can eat more than that, I get my picture on the wall and the honor of renaming the challenge.
So is this your first roast grill dog?
This is actually my third today.
You think you can finish it?
No, yeah.
Now what's on that one?
It's mustard, onions, chili, and slaw. You can't get this kind of hot dog up north.
The challenge will be easy, man. These are good.
What would your strategy be?
Eat fast.
Eat fast. I love it. I truly feel like I am getting advice from the Buddha.
But if you don't find Buddha's guidance, you'll at least find chili. Because the Roast Grill prides itself on a recipe nearly 100 years old that Greek immigrants George and Mary Charles brought to Raleigh when they set up shop back in 1940. And today, their grandson, George Pinheiros, stays true to those same homemade flavors.
You've caught me in the middle of making one of my grand batches of chili. I do it about once a week.
Now, chili is like the key ingredient, key component.
Hot dog chili to top hot dogs. It's not made for anything else.
George first simmers three onions for half a day till they're incredibly soft. Then adds in spices from his family's unique recipe and finally mixes in 20 pounds of ground beef.
Took me a year to get it to taste right. It's got a heavy oomph to it, doesn't it?
It does. It's that classic chili smell. It's all that great stuff with a little bit of obviously the chili powder behind it. Oh, that's like the perfect consistency for hot dogs. Loads of flavor. You know me, got a little bit of a kick on it. I want to finish the rest of the spoon. So it's sort of the chili that sets the dogs here apart from anywhere else.
It's like that and the certain wiener. We got a very special wiener. Comes from Michigan.
Now you're just bragging. Every guy thinks his is special. I'm just kidding.
You won't find generic ballpark dogs here, because at the Roast Grill, every Frank is 90% beef with just a bit of lean pork flavor and uniquely cooks to a perfect crispy black char on the 70-year-old original grill.
There is flavor, like cooked right into
built here. Into that slab. It'll never go away. That's why you can't copy it. There's exactly one factory left for these wieners. It's in Michigan. There's nothing like that wiener.
This chili dog is gonna get burned twice today.
It's challenge time. 16 crispy Franks topped with a full pint of chili. Over 100 have attempted, but couldn't cut the mustard. But I'm ready to tame these dogs and make the challenge mine.
In order for me to win the Roast Grill Hot Dog Challenge, I need to harness the power of the entire triangle. The power of UNC, of Duke, and NC State. Let's hear it for the North Carolina Triangle!
I'm I'm ready to shatter the record of this hot dog heaven, so George delivers the first tray of dogs.
I come to you with your first 5 hot dogs. You have 1 hour. 16 ties the record, 17 hot dogs takes the record.
Roast Grill of Raleigh, my first bite. My first bite!
I down that dog in just 3 bites and know that this is gonna be a tasty challenge.
The burnt dog makes all the difference. I love the crunchiness of it. The chili has all those spices in it. And the only problem I foresee are the buns. Right when the bun's about to kick my booty, the chili just comes in and saves the day. Keep him coming, almost done with 5.
I'm telling you, he's putting them away pretty fast. He's about 2 or 2.5 bites per hot dog.
Well, these damn buns, man, the buns are killing me.
The buns are expanding in my gut, but I pound through dogs 6 through 10, and George brings out a third tray with Frank's 11 through 16.
These 6 tie the record. There will be only 1 left to eat to break the record.
Staying focused through the first 10. Got 6 more, got the record right in front of me.
He's got it made. He's way ahead of the game.
13 down, 4 to go to break the record.
4 more dogs.
I plowed through a baker's dozen in just 22 minutes, but my pace is slowing, and the final 4 dogs aren't gonna go down easy.
The buns are monsters.
Yeah, he's struggling. Every time he takes a bite, he just wants to come back up, but he's somehow gonna have to keep it down.
You're gonna make me so proud.
You're gonna make me so sick.
So sick.
All right, Adam, now you can do it, buddy.
Thank you.
Do it for me.
Right? For you, I would. For you, I would. Name one guy who wouldn't for this race. Look at this guy.
A beautiful woman to my left, a Carolina crowd cheering to my right, and a record-tying chili dog under my nose. I chomp away on number 16 and get ready for the final Frank.
You stop cheering and make my last hot dog.
Record breaker!
Last one.
The crowd comes in close as I get ready for my history-making hot dog. 16 dogs, each covered with mustard and homemade chili, already sit in my stomach. And now, with the good people of the North Carolina Triangle watching, I'm up to my final bite.
To now rename this challenge the Man versus Food Roast Grill Challenge. And today in the battle of Man versus Food in the Raleigh, North Carolina, Durham, North Carolina, Chapel Hill, North Carolina Triangle, today in the battle of Man versus Food, Man won!
Chili a factor.
The chili was indeed a factor. It was super duper hot, which gave me something to focus on other than the cement truck in my stomach made of chili dog. Yes.
So how's it feel to beat the record?
It means a lot because of the support I had, the history of this place, and the fact that now this challenge bears the Man versus Food name. Holla at your boy.